Hi guys, this is Sharon, and let's see, what time is it? It's still morning. I am going to try and do a speed up how I paint my Reborns. So I'm going to do a series of clips when I'm, painting each layer, and then put them all together and try to figure out how to do the speed thing. But I am not going to film my actual painting because I've done that before. Here is the color that I mixed for the first layer. And once again, I used this. First, I started with distilled water. And I put quarter of a cup of distilled water. And then this is coming to its end, so I had a very thick glob of it and put it in there and pounced it and smushed it to get it to disperse in the water. Pardon me, I have a frog in my throat. Then I mixed these three colors. Let's see if I can get closer. Rose pink, parchment, and crushed coral to get that. And I put two coats on the doll. And I told you that I use my brush and I brush it all over the vinyl. I do each piece separately. I brush it on the vinyl first, and then I take my cosmetic wedge and pounce it onto the vinyl. Okay. So that's, and I'm actually keeping track this time of the colors that I'm using and the steps that I'm doing so that I can be more systematic and, what's the word I'm looking for? the same, keep it all the same steps, uniform. So, especially because Michaela is a twin, I'm going to try to duplicate her with her little brother, Micah. Okay, so this was two coats of this. So that's all so far. So stay tuned for more later. Bye-bye. Good afternoon, guys. I decided to do the first layer of shading and veining. I used Midnight. And you can see the vein coming down the side of her forehead. I put the blue in between her eyes on the bridge of her nose and right here on the sides of her nose, and the shading on her bottom lip in those three sections. I gave her a little blue at the corners of her eyes. Don't know if you can tell, I put a little blue in the inner portion of her ear and started the veining on her head. Gave her some veining on her feet and her legs and her hands, and in between her fingers I put some blue, and in between her toes, like right at the base. And put some blue right here in the middle of her foot and in the middle of her hand. This is going to require several layers. So that's the next thing I did. Okay, the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to use this flesh batch and I'm going to add some black cherry to it and start the creasing. And so I will let you know and stay tuned for part three. Okay, good morning. Another day of project on Michaela. I put some of this color, which was the black cherry, mixed in with a tiny bit of blue. And I did another layer of creasing, And I did a couple layers of mottling using that. And of course I pinked her lips and her nostrils and her eyes. She has her inner ears darkened a little. So she had the bottoms of her feet pinked a little. And her hands. So her mottling's coming along beautifully. So, yeah. The next thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to add another all over layer of color. And it's probably going to be either purple, blue, green, or yellow. Or all of the above. Okay, so stay tuned. Okay, folks, the last thing that I did today is I added a watery blue, purple blue wash to all over the kit, and you might not be able to tell, but that's just the way it is with painting a Reborn. It's a slow go. So, okay, probably the next layer is going to be a yellowy reddish brown layer. Okay, folks, this is probably going to be the last video that I'm going to do today. I put two layers of warming on Michaela. So once again, it's a subtle change, and this is the color. It's very watery, very, very watery consistency. And these are the colors that I used. I started with yellow ochre, of course, with the water and the glass and tile medium. And then I added, since I don't have folk art brick, I used Craft Smart brick red. And I put a touch of real brown to arrive at this nice warm color, golden color. And I put two layers of that on her. The beauty of human skin is that it's a combination of warm and cool colors. Cool colors being blues, greens, and purples. And warm colors being reds, yellows, oranges, and golden browns. So that's the real art of reborning, is deciding where to put the cool colors and where to put the warm colors, and how to shade, how to mottle, how to do realistic veins. And each time I reborn, I get better. I learn more. So yeah, so okay. That's it for today. I am going to my Thursday Bible study with my ladies that I love so much, and maybe I'll do some painting later, maybe I won't, but stay tuned. Hi guys, it's getting dark, so I have to stop. I came home and did one more thing. I added more pigment to the wash to warm up the doll, and this is what I used. I used yellow ochre, real brown, brick red, and a touch of medium yellow to get this color, and came up with this. So she's starting to come to life. The lighting is terrible right now because it's getting dark, but I am recording this for you guys so you can see how I do a complete reborn doll. Okay, good night, guys. Stay tuned tomorrow for more. Good morning, guys. Welcome to my messy workspace, my dining room. I did another layer of mottling, blushing, and creasing on Michaela. She's starting to come alive. And this is the color I used, which is mostly the black cherry. Can't remember now if I added anything else to it, but there's the black cherry, and that's the color. So I added a lot more pigment to it this time in order to get it to be a little bit deeper. So there she is. Her feet are getting nice and pink. Her hands are getting nice and pink. My mother-in-law's bird is happy, chirping away here. So look at those little tiny lips. Look at that little delicate face. Let me try moving the light and see if that, yeah, that right there was a little better. Andy's here with me. I'm still in my PJs. That's Andy's, where he eats, just in case you were wondering. So I'm going to be doing some purples and blues next, and maybe some little bit of yellows here and there. So stay tuned. Hi guys, I'm working on my doll, and I put a tiny bit of very, very watered down and brushed on my paper towel yellow on her nose. I used this color, like a bluish purple, on her eyelids and underneath her chin and on the ball of her foot, or actually in the center of the bottom of her foot, and the same with the tops of her feet right here. The tops of her hands right there. So, yeah. So I guess the next thing will be more getting her cheeks a little redder, and maybe put a warming layer on her. So stay tuned. And meanwhile, look at what it's doing out there. It's snowing. Yeah, we got a lot of snow. My husband did go to work. Okay, that's it for now. Stay tuned for more. Hope you are getting something out of this. Hello. I came up with this color by adding engine red, black cherry, and the brick red. And I used some of the old flesh color that I had, and to make it a little milkier looking. And kind of a dark rose color, rose pink. And I pinked up her cheeks, her forehead, her lips, her feet, her knees, the bottoms of her hands, because she needed a little more pinking. So the next layer is going to be this warming layer. And then I'm going to start her hair. Yeah, I'm getting pretty far on her. I'm working hard on her. So stay tuned for what she looks like with her warming layer. Hi guys. So with this warming layer, which is this color right here, it was just the right consistency for me to brush it on her and not have to pounce it with the cosmetic wedge. So at this stage of the process, the vinyl was readily accepting the paint smoothly and evenly. No streaks or pooling or anything. So I was able to keep the paint on her from the brush and just use my hair dryer, my blow dryer, to dry her. Didn't have to use the cosmetic wedges at all. So I'm glad about that because you take a little bit of the paint off when you pounce it with the wedges. And I wanted this warming layer to be a little bit more pronounced on her, and it is. So she is looking. Let me get over here, see if I can get better lighting. Nope. I don't know. Better lighting. There she is. I love her. She is so adorable. Yeah, the light is not. Sorry, I'm making you dizzy. Her lips will look different when they are glossed. Right now they look a little pale. I might add another layer of red on her lips and then start her hair, her eyebrows first. Okay, folks, so yeah, that's the warming layer that I applied with my brush. No sponging this time. I used a regular hair dryer, blow dryer, and kept it about 8 inches from the vinyl so it didn't scorch the vinyl. You definitely don't want to scorch your vinyl. Okay, guys, I did a lot of work on this doll, and I kind of lost track of writing everything down, but I did more layering of the creases, did more, I did her hair, I did her eyebrows. This is the color I used. I used a combination of Van Dyke brown and real brown. I started out with the real brown and then I added the Van Dyke brown to make a darker color. So, let me show you that side. Here's the back. This side. And there's the top. So next will be the nail tips. And then the matte varnish and baking the doll, and then the eyelashes, and then the glossing, and then the gluing. Gluing the magnet for the pacifier and gluing the inside of the eyelashes. So yeah, I guess you could say I'm almost done. I worked on this doll all day today, so I hope you like her. Stay tuned for more. Okay, guys, so I have decided not to matte varnish this baby because she is not the least bit shiny, and I'm hoping that she will remain that way. I just finished glossing her nails and rooting her eyelashes and glossing her lips. So I also glued a magnet behind her mouth, and she's going to have a tiny little pacifier, and I'm going to wait for her nails to dry and then fill her with glass beads and put her on her body. So I'm excited, and I hope you guys are too. So the next video you see will be Michaela completely reborn. Okay. And I decided, along with my friend, that we were going to name this baby Clover, since she's going to be born very close to St. Patrick's Day. And she's a very delicate little girl. And I really liked the name Clover. So her name is going to be Clover. So stay tuned for her reborn and in a cute little outfit. Bye, folks. Okay, guys, here she is, Miss Long-Awaited Clover, and I have her in green for her namesake, Clover, and This is a preemie size onesie, and it just fits her. So she's probably a large preemie size. I think newborn might be too big for her, so getting the right size preemie clothing for her would be perfect. She's got full legs and full arms. She's not jointed. But she's got that kind of body where you can work with it. Yeah, you can. You can put her arm like that and her arm up like that and her leg over like that. So yeah, I just finished weighting her and putting her together. So please welcome Clover. Okay guys, you have been with me through this whole process, except for the actual painting, which I cannot do on camera. I just can't. It's just too hard to do it on camera, but I showed you how I did it, and I am proud of the way I weighted her also. She looks perfect. She's got a joined chest and butt. So she's got a little tush on her, and her head is floppy. She's just a really delicate little flower, a little clover flower. Yeah, so wave to your aunties and uncles, Clover. And let me show you her hair again. I love the way her hair came out. My husband likes the hair too. I always run everything by him. He's a good critic. He told me he thought the eyebrows were a bit arched, which I don't think they are. And he was a good critic. He helped me with the eyelashes, particularly. Okay, that's it for now. Stay tuned for more videos with little Clover. Thanks for being with me through this journey. Bye-bye, folks.